Hi, Senator. Good.
First of all, I'm just incredibly impressed by your ability to field these questions. You're being cross-examined by, you know, a number of assemblymen and senators and doing a great job. I want to echo what Senator Young had to say about the 219 connector. It really is a regional bipartisan issue that we'd love the DOT to look at. And it really opens up a corridor from Toronto, whether it be to, you know, right, Miami or Maryland and Pennsylvania.
And it's very important for us. Thank you. On talking about Region 5, which is Western New York, you know, we've talked about parity, and you're probably sick of hearing about it, but in Region 5, we have 12.5% of the roads and bridges. And in my county, Erie County, we have the most road miles of any county in the state by the DOT. And our funding level is at less than 9%, probably about 8.5% is what we're getting in Region 5 right now. How are we looking at the parity formula? And I know you've asked this in a number of ways, but I'm asking it from a sheer percentage standpoint. You know, we've got 12.5% of the roads and bridges, we're getting 8.5% of the funding. That's not parity as I see it. So how do you address that?
Well, I think you have to address it. You know, you work with a certain amount, but you have to address it in terms of what the conditions are in a given area, Region 5 or elsewhere. The use, the number of users of a particular roadway or bridge or what have you. And I think that plays a lot into it. And again, I mentioned safety because at the end of the day, you know, if a particular roadway is unsafe or a particular bridge, we want to work, whether it's the state or with locals, to ensure that it becomes safe. So that's generally how we view it. I think there's a tendency, perhaps I've heard in the past, where people think, well, you know, one particular area gets more money because they may have more people or not. And that's really not the case. Of course, you know, dollars in this day and age, whatever venue you're in, are always very competitive, as I think we could all agree. We have a big system with a lot of need. You know, the percentage of our bridges are in pretty good shape, both local and state, probably somewhere about 72% in good shape. There's challenges in other areas, obviously, and our roadways are generally in good shape. But as we continue to see the climate changes that we've experienced over the last few years, you know, that really impacts conditions as well. So we're not playing favorites. We're really trying to take a methodical, thoughtful analysis of the system in its entirety. It may not always equate to a particular percentage, but we try to look ahead at what the needs are given that criteria.
And I want you to understand, I'm not one of these, you know, upstate senators who is anti the MTA. I understand the economic impact,
right,
and I support, you know, full funding of, you know, MTA spending and infrastructure spending.
Right.
But in upstate, you know, we have drivers, we're undergoing a renaissance in Western New York, and, you know, as I talk to building contractors, you know, we're building Solar City, we've got a medical campus, you know, we need the roads and bridges to improve capacity,
right,
so that we can utilize these wonderful facilities we're building. So I just want you, as you're looking at, you know, hopefully a five-year DOT plan, I'm not sure if we're going to get a five-year plan in this year, but I think it's important to look at those percentages and dollar values, and, you know, we want to get our fair share, and it's not to slight the MTA. We need to build up the MTA, and I support the spending in the city on those projects. On a separate issue, I was looking at the budget, and there's a five-year extreme weather infrastructure hardening program appropriation.
Right.
We couldn't find it in your agency's appropriation. How are those projects going to be selected and funded?
Well, again, it'll be by analysis. You know, we'll look at historic data, and there's plenty of that. You know, I just mentioned there's been a significant change in the last several years of weather patterns. So whether it's, you know, been these vortexes that we've had, and thankfully we haven't experienced that this year. But if you look at Hurricane Irene or Tropical Storm Lee or certainly Superstorm Sandy, things are changing. And so with those changes, and particular, you know, location plays a role in that. If you're in the Hudson Valley, as an example, where you've got, you know, high hills and narrow roadways, we've seen impacts that we hadn't seen before. The governor smartly, in my opinion, you know, is placing money now for us to go out and identify where those particular roadways may be. Perhaps there's work, grading work, or other things that we might be able to do to prevent flooding of a parkway, or how we really look at culverts. You know, I come from, in my previous work with the state, you know, working with water and sewer infrastructure. And, you know, that's something that I've been broaching and discussing with our people as we think about long-term. Stormwater management is becoming a critically important issue. It's really changed, you know, over the last 5-6 years. And it's an area that I want DOT to change with, too, because we need to be smart about how we also direct waters from our systems, because likely they could impact locals. So the long or the short answer is that, you know, we are going to take a careful look and analysis to see historically where these roads have largely been impacted because of severe weather, and we hope to make a difference with those funds. There's $500 million now that he's appropriated in this proposed budget to do so, and I think it's money well spent based on what we've seen over the course, certainly of the last 6 years.
Well, since you mentioned stormwater, I may be the only senator that knows what, you know, a stormwater protection plan is, you know, as provided by the New York State Department of Transportation. I mean, I've looked at specs and plans and you know, dealt with contractors in this regard. But that follows up my next question, and this goes to what the assemblyman was asking earlier about, you know, where we are in our staffing. And I know I've asked the DOT last year to give me some of the economic justifications for the so-called cost savings on the consultants that we're using, and really this contracting out issue of engineers and, you know, people who are on site, you know, doing inspections. Inspections, right. And engineers has been a big part of what DOT does.
Right.
And I know in Western New York and Region 5, I think all of our inspection is contracted out. So I'd like to know what the economic analysis the DOT has done to really quantify whether or not there have been real cost savings in doing that.
Well, you know, the straight answer is I've not seen that. I intend to look at it. It's one of the historical things that's taken place at DOT, you know, before my arrival. But I would say that, again, from kind of an operational or a business perspective, you know, we have a strong engineering force that, as you know, does a lot of things, a lot of important things. So we augment that with consultants, engineers, to support the efforts of not only, you know, our local folks, but to go out on case-by-case or special project areas and provide resources that perhaps we might not have. But I think there's a second piece here that we should think about, which is, you know, while DOT, in my opinion, has adequate staffing to continue to deliver, while we also utilize the private sector for engineering work, we are also supporting another economy as well. These are people that live in all of our communities, who go to our local grocery store, who pay our property taxes, who send their kids to our school and pay school taxes as well. So I look at it in the sense that while we do utilize contractors or vendors to support our engineering services, we're also helping support another sector of the economy in New York State.
And I completely understand that. I mean, but, you know, and as I said, Region 5 DOT, Daryl Kaminsky, the director there, has been incredibly responsive. But, you know, as I talk to contractors and labor folks, you know, they really ascribe the, you know, lack of engineering infrastructure, you know, as the reason why, you know, we're not getting contracts let in an appropriate time frame. And as we talked about, we have a limited construction window to build in New York State. It's more limited in Western New York.
Right.
And so when a project goes out to bid in November and we're not breaking ground until June, that's a problem. We're losing 2 or 3 months of the construction season. And it's really, I think, incumbent upon the DOT to be looking at that to make those projects work in Region 5 and all of the upstate regions in a timely fashion. We want to get construction workers in the field in April and not in June.
I agree with you. And, you know, that's part of the, you know, kind of evaluation that I've been doing. I've made some changes already operationally, administratively at the Department of Transportation, policy-wise. But that is an area that I'm looking at and will be looking at. I hear you. I mean, I've heard this from other people, and I experienced it myself years ago. It's a big ship. But, you know, look, we can find ways that we also can modernize ourselves and be more efficient. You know, somebody mentioned earlier about cross-training. It's another area that I'm interested in. While many people have specialized areas in DOT, I'm a big believer in cross-training. You know, so that people are able to do and function in more than one capacity. And I'm not suggesting that they can't. What I'm suggesting is perhaps it's not utilized to the degree it should be. That'll be part of my evaluation as I continued forward in this role.
Well, I'm looking forward to working with you on that, and as you address that economic analysis, I'd really like to be able to share that with the Senate Assembly to see whether or not we really have saved money by downsizing from our public employees.
Okay, good enough, fair enough.
Thank you.
Thank you.